TikTok is being banned on federal government devices amid concerns the Chinese-owned app poses serious security risks. Let's bring in Attorney General Mark Dreyfus in Canberra. Attorney General, thanks for your time this morning. Is that all true?
Morning, Carl. The government's been considering advice from agencies. When we have an announcement to make, we'll make it.
When will that be? I mean, it's been on your desk for a while.
We've been considering advice. We do things in a considered way, Carl, and we'll be taking a decision that is in the best interests of the Australian public and in the best interests of national security.
It's either a threat or it's not.
As I say, we've had the advice from agencies. We'll be making a decision when we're able to make it.
The state governments have already banned it, haven't they?
There's been bans in place now on government devices in a range of other countries, but we are considering this and will be making a decision in due course.
It can't be that big a threat if the consideration is going this long.
Let's think about this, Carl. The former government was completely inactive on this for years. Mm. The TikTok app's been in use in Australia since 2017.
Okay, and you're not being exactly active either.
When we've got a decision to announce, we'll announce it.
Does it send an odd message, do you think, China, us muscling up from a security perspective with the subs and then having state premiers go to China and also Anthony Albanese saying, I'm happy to go to China, to have a muscled-up Navy with our most significant trading partner?
I don't see this in terms of messaging. I see this in terms of taking decisions that are in Australia's best interests and with national security at the heart of them.
All right. Well, how would you sum up what TikTok is then? Can you give us some detail on what the government is looking at, the parameters of it, and how big a threat it might be, given what you've seen so far?
Well, I'm not going to go into what the security advice is, Carl. This is a social messaging app, and the security advice deals with what risks it poses. And when we've got a decision to announce, we will announce it.
Do you think it's far away, that decision?
You're really trying this morning, Carl. I'll repeat, when we've got a decision to announce, we will make that decision.
All right, well, TikTok has been banned on all government devices. Let's bring in General Manager of TikTok Australia and New Zealand, Lee Hunter. Thanks for your time, Lee. Now, we are still waiting for that confirmation. Do you know any more?
We don't, but I think the first thing to say is Aussies are absolutely safe on TikTok. We care deeply. We're absolutely focused on their privacy and security. But at the moment, we don't know what's happening. We're finding out about this through the media. We've had repeated attempts to try and meet with government about this, but unfortunately, it's been very disappointing what's happening so far.
You do keep trying to reassure the Australian public that they are safe, but we all know that obviously the Chinese government, any Chinese company, is beholden to the Chinese government, and if they want that data, they can grab it.
Well, we have a few issues with that being proposed, but the main thing that's happening here is these actions are being undertaken without any facts, without any evidence to support the fact that we're a national security risk in any way. The only thing we can point to is what's happening is being driven by politics and based on our country of origin. There are no facts or evidence to support any of this. That's why we want to meet with the government.
But like I said, we do know that the Chinese government owns any kind of data that Chinese companies have.
Well, look, if that's the concern of the governments, then they should also be concerned about the telecommunications companies, the healthcare companies, the banks that are Australian that also have employees based in China. If we're being singled out purely because of our country of origin, I think there are big questions to be asked around that, and we don't think it's fair, not to us or the millions of Australians that love TikTok.
Well, there are around 8 million Australians who are on TikTok. I mean, the confusion that surrounds this is something that we need to eradicate straight away. I mean, you'd like to have clarity, wouldn't you?
We'd love to have clarity, and not just for us, but again, for those millions of Aussies and the hundreds of thousands of small businesses that rely on TikTok to grow their businesses. We're a really important part of Australian culture now and the economy too. I think we deserve to have that dialogue with the government about what's happening.
It's hard to know whether the horse has bolted when it comes to this and if data has already been mined. What do you think this will mean if TikTok is wiped from government devices to begin with? It could expand, right?
Well, I think the first thing is if we're being singled out purely because of our country of origin, I think there are big questions to be asked around that. But if we're... What's happening here? We don't know the detail. Are government employees now going to be still able to use their TikTok... their Twitter, their Facebook, go on dating apps? I mean, we just don't have the detail at the moment. We think it's quite unfair and we want to have that meeting with them.
What do you think will happen, though, to those users of TikTok now? They'll go elsewhere? You'll lose your stronghold?
No, this is just with government devices. So, again, to be clear, for Australians out there, the millions of Australians that love and use TikTok, they're absolutely safe on our platform. That's our number one priority. Look, we're still growing. We know that those users love and trust us, but there's something different happening with government that we really want to meet with them and understand more about.
It sounds like time is ticking, though, on the government devices at least, Lee. Thanks so much for your time, Carl. Let's come back home now, and the PM has called time on TikTok, banning the Chinese-owned app on all government devices over fears it could be a tool to spy on politicians. Bill, what will this mean for your career as a TikTok influencer?
Well, it means that an otherwise anonymous career just becomes even more anonymous.
Come on, you're pretty big, 15,000 followers or something, that's handy.
Yeah, it's something, isn't it? But, no, I think the story today says the Prime Minister's thinking about it. I don't think a final decision has been formally made. But there is, right across the world, I should say, governments are advising and deciding that government phones and assets should not have TikTok on it for fear that it's being utilised by the Chinese government. Yeah. The Europeans, the Americans, we're all sort of moving in the same direction. Mm. So I think if that's the best advice of the security agencies, then we follow it. I mean, I've gone off TikTok formally and I've got a way up even if I'd stay on it in a private capacity using non-government phones. I think if that's the way the world's going, we've got to follow the advice.
Yeah, and quickly, Neil, has the horse already bolted here? Is it too late to delete it?
Well, I don't know about that. I'm not a cybersecurity expert, but this whole thing leaves me thoroughly confused. So we're spending $368 billion buying submarines because we want to protect ourselves against China in 50 years' time. We're banning TikTok because it's owned by the Chinese government. We're worried about it infiltrating the government. Yet you've got Dan Andrews can't get to China quick enough. He was like the roadrunner, just left dust behind him. Mark McGowan, the West Australian Premier, is going there in a couple of weeks' time. Anastasia Palaszczuk is going there. And on the same page where there's a story today saying the Prime Minister's banning TikTok, the Prime Minister's quoted as saying, I'll go to China if I'm invited too. So what is it? Are we in with China or do we hate them? Are they going to blow us up?
No, Neil. Simple answer,
Very quickly,
Neil, is
Bill.
Australians can, governments can walk and chew gum. We can maintain our national security, but still seek to improve our trade position. It's just the world we live in. We have to do more than one thing at a time.
Yes, it's a delicate dance as always. Big news day today. Thank you so much for your time, guys.
Cheers.
Carl.